Today we discuss session 3.46, characteristic equation. If a square matrix of order n, we can form the matrix A minus lambda I, where lambda is a scalar and I is the unit matrix, that is identity matrix of order n. Then the determinant of the matrix equal to 0, that is A minus determinant A minus lambda I equal to determinant of this. A minus lambda I is obtained from the matrix A and lambda I. We know that the matrix A can be written as A11 etc. A1n etc. An1 etc. Ann. And the matrix lambda I is I is a identity matrix, so we have lambda over the diagonals and rest of the entries are 0. So subtracting this matrix A minus lambda, you will get A11 minus lambda in the second term, A12 minus 0, that is A12 itself. Okay, so by taking difference and taking the determinant, you will get this determinant. That is equal to 0 is called the characteristic equation. Characteristic equation of A. So one thing we should remember is only the square matrix we have used. Okay, that means the characteristic equation is defined only for square matrix. Okay, so there are so many ways to introduce this characteristic equation. So I follow the method we see in the prescribed textbook itself. So you can either you can use another method using the linear transformations as well. Now, expanding this determinant, you can get the leading term is minus 1 raised to n lambda raised to n plus when you expand this, that will be a polynomial or that will be an expression, algebraic expression in lambda, and we collect the terms or we write the those algebraic expression in the descending order of the powers of lambda. So this is minus 1 raised to n lambda raised to n, and the coefficient of lambda raised to n minus 1 is k1 plus etc. kn equal to 0. This is what we call the characteristic equation. This is obtained by expanding this equation. Now roots of this equation, this is a polynomial in lambda. The roots of this equation is called characteristic roots. So characteristic roots are obtained by solving this equation. Okay. This characteristic roots also called latent roots or eigenvalues. Eigenvalues is same as characteristic values. Eigenvalues of A, characteristic values of A, or latent values of A. Now the sum of the eigenvalues of matrix A is equal to trace of A, because when you expand this, we know that once you expand this determinant, you will get this equation, and we know that the roots of this equation is the characteristic values. So the interesting fact is, when you expand this determinant, you will get k1. What is k1? K1 is the sum of, or minus k1, you can write it, as minus k1. Minus k1 is the sum of roots of the equation. Then this this minus k is this is actually the expansion of or extension of the formula x minus a into x minus b. Suppose this is the these are a and b are the roots of this equation, this polynomial. We write this polynomial as x square minus a plus b into x plus ab. So this is what we call the sum of roots. So this is obtained from this equation by taking up to a minus sign. If you write this as multiplying this with minus 1 raised to n, you can get a minus sign here. So this is the coefficient of lambda raised to n minus 1 is what we called minus of the sum of roots. So this will give the trace of this matrix. okay, trace of A, not this matrix, trace of A. So you will get A11 plus A22 plus etc. ANN. So this is an interesting fact. We are not going to prove this result right now because it requires some concepts of linear algebra. So I leave it as a result here. So the result is interesting. The trace is nothing but this the roots of or the sum of eigenvalues or the coefficient of lambda raised to n minus 1. Now we have section 3.47, eigenvectors. Once you consider a square matrix A and the corresponding system of linear equations y is equal to ax, then we can consider this this x as A is an n by n matrix here, and x is x1 etc xn, and y is again y1 etc yn. So if A is n by matrix, this should be an n by 1, consequently this will be an n by n. So what is the role of this A? This A transform this x to the matrix of the same order y. Okay, so A transform this x to y. Now if we consider some element of x which are mapped to a multiple of x itself, okay, by this A, we need to consider this type of elements. Obviously this 0 satisfies this condition. When x equal to 0, then we know that ax is also 0. So A transform the 0 to 0 vector to or 0 matrix to 0 matrix itself. So we are concentrating on a non-zero such number. Okay. So our intention is to get this type of y is equal to lambda x. Then we have ax is equal to lambda x. That means x is transformed to lambda x. This is possible, or if this happens, we can get ax minus lambda I times x equal to 0. This ix is same as x itself. Okay, so this can be written as A minus lambda I into x equal to 0. Okay, this A minus lambda is nothing but A11 minus lambda A12 etc A1n A21 A22 minus lambda etc A2n etc An1 etc ANn minus lambda. This is our A minus lambda I. This times x, x is x1, x2, etc., xn. So, determinant of this matrix. This matrix is, when we multiply this with this, you can get this system of linear equations. Then, we know that if the this is the coefficient matrix of this system, I call it as coefficient matrix. If this coefficient determinant of this coefficient matrix is non-zero, then A inverse exists, then you can get x1, x2, xn as 0, 0, 0. So it has only a trivial solution. Otherwise, you can get the determinant of this is this coefficient matrix is a 0, then you can get non-zero solution for this. Because this is now it is a homogeneous system. We know that for a homogeneous system, solution exists, it is always consistent. Hence, in order to get a non-zero value for this x1, x2, xn, we need to assume that determinant of the coefficient matrix is always 0. So, this is what we called characteristic equation in the previous section. Then, A minus lambda equal to determinant of A minus lambda equal to 0 will give the characteristic values or eigenvalues for A. Then if we solve the system A minus lambda, determinant of A minus lambda equal to 0, you can get lambda. Corresponding to this lambda, you can get a non-zero solution for Ax equal to lambda x. That non-zero solution is what we called eigenvector or latent vector or characteristic vector. So this is the definition of characteristic vector. Characteristic vector is nothing but the non-zero solution of this Ax minus lambda x or A minus lambda I or into x equal to 0. Now we can discuss one example. Find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix A. A is a 2 by 2 matrix. Then determinant of A minus lambda equal to 0, this is the characteristic equation. So when you substitute the values for the elements of A, we can get A minus lambda is the matrix 1 minus lambda minus 2 minus 5 4 minus lambda. Then determinant of this is equal to 0. By evaluating this determinant, you can get 1 minus lambda into 4 minus lambda minus product of these two numbers, that is 10, that is equal to 0. Then factorizing this, first you simplify this one, lambda square minus 5 lambda minus 6 equal to 0. Then factorizing, you can get lambda minus 6 into lambda plus 1 equal to 0. Or you can write lambda is equal to 6 and lambda equal to minus 1. So these are the characteristic values or Lytton values. Next we will find the eigenvectors, characteristic vectors corresponding to lambda equal to minus, lambda is equal to 6. First then, in order to get the eigenvectors, we need to solve this, a minus 6i x equal to 0. So a minus 6i is obtained by this, by substituting the value of lambda 6 here. So you can get this system, a minus 6i into x equal to 0. By simplifying this, you can get this system. We need to solve this system of equation. So first you, in order to solve the system of equation, we need to find the rank of this matrix. We know that the rank of this matrix is 1 because these two rows are same. So rank is 1. So we need to consider the equation minus 5x1 minus 2x2 equal to 0. So we know that this is a 1 linear equation and 2 unknown. So this has infinitely many solutions for this equation. So in order to get the infinitely many solution, there are so many ways to find the value of x1 and x2. One way is to substitute the value of x2 as a constant here, then solve for this x1 in terms of that constant. In this case, we can use another idea. We can easily find out this 5 x1 is equal to minus 5 x1 is equal to 2 x2 by transposing this to that side. Then you can write x1 by 2 is same as minus x2 by 5, that is equal to some k. So from this you can solve for this x1 and minus x2. So we can get x1 is equal to 2 and x2 is equal to 2k and x2 is equal to minus 5k. So x1, x2 will give 2k minus 5k, and this is equal to, by taking k outside, you can get this is k times 2 minus 5. So for any value of this k, this form eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equal to 6. For the particular value, for putting k is equal to 1, we can say that 2 minus 5 is the characteristic vector, one of the characteristic vectors corresponding to lambda equal to 6. This is the way we evaluate the characteristic vectors corresponding to a characteristic value lambda equal to 6. Next, we will find the characteristic value corresponding to lambda equal to minus 1.
In order to get the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to minus 1, we need to solve a minus of minus 1 lambda into x equal to 0. Lambda I into x equal to 0, that is a plus I into x equal to 0. Then what is a plus I? A plus I is 2 minus 2 minus 5, 5 into x. What is x here? X is x1, x2 into 0, 0. We need to solve the system of equation. Obviously, this the rank of this matrix is again 0. When multiply this with minus 5 by 2, you'll get the same row here. Okay, by multiplying this with minus 5 by 2, you'll get the
same row here. So we can say that it has only one independent row. So the rank of this matrix is A, rank of this matrix is 1. Then again, exactly what we have done in previous case, you can get one equation, that is 2x1 minus 2x2 equal to 0. By putting x2 is equal to some number c, we can write x1 as again c. Okay, when you transpose this to right, then you will get 2x1 equal to 2x2. From that, you can get x1 is equal to x2, that is same as c. So we can replace the c is as k2, you can write x1 x2 as c comma c, that is nothing but c times 1 1. So that is exactly what we have written here. So this is the way we find out the characteristic vectors of a square matrix. And another interesting result is, if these are the eigenvalues corresponding or characteristic values corresponding to the matrix A, then A cube has the latent values or eigenvalues lambda 1 cube, lambda 2 cube, etc., lambda n cube. So if you know the eigenvalues of A, you can get the eigenvalues of A cube. Okay, we know that if lambda is an eigenvalue, then this satisfies, or there exists a non-zero x such that Ax equal to lambda x if lambda is an eigenvalue. So from this you can write A square by multiplying A on both sides, you can get, or multiplying A square on both sides, you can get A square times this is equal to A square times lambda x. A square into A is same as A cube x. That is equal to A square into lambda x can be written as lambda into, lambda is a scalar, so that can be taken out, lambda into A square x. Okay, but this A square x is again, you can write it as lambda into A into x. Okay, this ax is again lambda x, then again one lambda can be out, then that will be A into x, then that ax can be replaced by again lambda x. Okay, that is what we have written here, a square x equal to A into x, this ax is lambda x, then we can take this lambda out, then again we have lambda into x, ax is again lambda x, so we have lambda square x. So we have A cube x equal to lambda cube x by substituting for this A square x. Okay, so we can get, we can say that for this matrix, this is eigenvalue. Okay, so whenever lambda is an eigenvalue for A, we can get lambda cube is an eigenvalue for A cube. That this shows that if lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n are eigenvalues of A, then cubes of these numbers, lambda 1 cube, lambda 2 cube, etc., lambda n cube, are the eigenvalues or latent values of this A cube. Okay, this not only this is not only true for n equal to 3, but this is true for every positive integer n. You can replace this 3 by any number. Okay, then lambda 1 raised to n, etc., lambda n raised to n, or if we consider a matrix of order, a matrix of power a raised to k, and lambda 1, lambda 2, etc., lambda n are the eigenvalues, then these values lambda 1 raised to k, etc., lambda n raised to k are the eigenvalues for this square matrix. Next we have an important example. This example, this can be considered as a theorem. If lambda is an eigenvalue of this matrix A, A is an invariant matrix, then lambda inverse is an eigenvalue of A inverse, provided A is non-singular. Only we can think about A inverse only if that matrix A is non-singular. So if A is non-singular, then lambda inverse or A inverse exists, and the eigenvalue of A inverse can be obtained from lambda. This lambda inverse means 1 by lambda. Okay, we need to prove that if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, then lambda 1 by lambda is an eigenvalue of A inverse. Next, the eigenvalue of adjoint A. In order to get this adjoint of A, we need not get this A as non-singular matrix. We can define adjoint of A for any square matrix A. So if in any case, but we know that if lambda if A is non-singular, then this results hold. Okay, even though adjoint A exists for every singular or non-singular matrix. This results only for non-singular matrices, okay? Because here we have 1 by lambda. For a singular matrix, this lambda can be a 0. So, this holds only for this lambda is non-zero. So, this result holds if A is non-singular. Okay, we need to prove these two conditions. These are very easy to show. If lambda is an eigenvalue, we can get a non-zero x such that Ax equal to lambda x. Okay, from this you can multiply this equation by A inverse. Okay, from both sides. From here we have A inverse Ax, that is Ix, that is equal to x itself. From RHS we can get A inverse into lambda x. This, since this lambda is x scalar, we can take it out. Then lambda times A inverse x. Okay, so this equation shows that 1 by lambda x equal to A inverse x. Okay, so this means A inverse x equal to lambda inverse x, that is 1 by lambda into x. It shows that eigenvalue of this matrix is lambda inverse, because this x is always a non-zero quantity. So this shows that lambda inverse is an eigenvalue of A inverse. Okay, next we have to prove that if we take lambda as an eigenvalue of A, we need to prove that determinant of A by lambda is the eigenvalue of adjoint of A. Okay, in order to prove that, we start with a non-zero vector. Since lambda is an eigenvalue, there exists a non-zero vector x such that this. Then we have an equation. By multiplying adjoint with both sides, we can get adjoint of A into Ax equal to adjoint of A into lambda of x. Adjoint of A into A is nothing but determinant of A into I. So this can be reduced to determinant of A into I, and this can be written as lambda can be taken out, then this will be adjoint of A into x. This shows that determinant of A into x, Ix is x, equal to lambda times adjoint of A into x. By transposing this lambda to the left side, you can get determinant of A by lambda into x equal to adjoint of A into x. Okay, this shows that adjoint of A into x equal to this number into x. Here this x is non-zero. Then we can say that the eigenvalue of adjoint of A is determinant of A by lambda. Clear? So this shows that lambda by determinant A by lambda is an eigenvalue of adjoint. Okay, this is the result. So this is an interesting result and it is very important. So next we will discuss section 3.48. I think that is the last section. So we can discuss the 3.48 in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.